Hi, this is Doris. Good afternoon. Today I'm going to be comparing time and expense entry in two different manufacturing applications that serve primarily the engineering and the architectural industries, although very applicable to consulting or service-based industries. So what you're going to see here today is a timesheet, and I'm going to walk through a couple of the navigational interface pieces, the period for my timesheet, that I'm just starting to work on this timesheet. I'm in the middle of my work week. And that the period actually runs. You can run these weekly, bi-weekly, semi-monthly, monthly in this application, range of date ranges. So this one's semi-monthly, 16th to the 30th. And you can see some time entries are already been put into the timesheet. So I'm going to actually put in a line of time. And I'm going to do it a couple of different ways so you get a feel of how to look a project, a customer, a job up, and how to necessarily code that. So if I just begin to type in, let's say, by alpha versus numeric, if I type in NOV, it's going to make a suggestion. Anything with NOV in it is going to come up as a suggested project or time entry. And I'm going to just type in, let's say, if I put a letter in there, so they, I don't match that, but if I look them up, I'm able to choose a phase, and then in turn I'm doing schematic design for Nova's telecom headquarters, and it's suggesting a budgeted labor code or an activity. I'm doing survey coordination, and I'm a senior consultant. So you get the swing of it pretty easily. I'm going to go out to an empty day here, and I'm going to go 5 hours. I've worked 5 hours, or I could have used my time clock to get me out to 5 hours. I think 2 to 7 gets me 5. And down here I can put some comments in. Comments for the day. So this is going to record to the project, to the labor task, if it had labor tasks or phases, and the day of the week that that occurred. I can just save at this point, and it's going to remember that next time I go to open that timesheet period. I could actually open that timesheet again, which is this week from the 16th to the 30th, or I can open another timesheet week, returning to that to maybe complete that week's worth of time. So I'm actually going to bring myself back where I was. And you can make a little tip here. You can kind of say, I always want to open up to the most current week of the year. So just to kind of quickly, I'm looking at projects. If I actually click on a column, I can sort that column. You can kind of see how things are sorting out. If you like the presentation being a little different, and there's some parameters in the configuration to slide around the column widths to make this a little bit more cosmetically pleasing. If I go to a line and I wanted to copy it to the next line and maybe just change over the task, I'm able to do that. So if I were to work on, I was doing design development, and that helps me out a little bit too. Maybe the same task number, and next day comes and I got 2 hours in for that. 2 to 2:30 to 3:30, calculate, comment. So I can save that. So a natural step, you may do this in paper timesheets or a system you're doing now, you submit this to accounting, and it has a feature in here to enter a password. I don't actually have a password in here right now, but that would establish electronic signature. And you can turn a feature on that kind of checks how many hours you have. If you're a 40-hour work week or an 88-hour work week, it's going to take a look at that. So now it's in a submittal role, and a supervisor would come in and then approve it, and then it goes from billing and payroll from that point forward. So if I were to pretend a second and I'm actually the supervisor, I can go in and see all the employees for this particular time period or another time period, and I can look in and I can go ahead and look at them or just switch them to an approved status. So if I were actually looking at Sally Little and I want to select her out, it brings up her timesheet, and I say, okay, that looks good to me. Ah, she missed a day. Let's ask her. Oh, she was sick that day, and I'm going to finish up her timesheet for her, or so I could actually send it back to her, and I'm going to just save out what I did. So now she's in good shape. So I'm going to submit her. Yeah, so for smaller organizations, you don't have to have all these steps. You don't have to have an approval step. It, you know, but as your organization grows, it may be important to you that you separate security for a variety of reasons, and I'm just going to kind of get a feel for that. So if I actually had authority to do the architectural department, for instance, I'm going to be able to bring those up and have rights to see those particular timesheets and then rotate through those timesheets to approve them. There's a little rotation button here, and I can submit and approve for them. This particular application actually goes down one more level. You're able to do some line item approval where you're not actually viewing the timesheet, but the project manager or supervisor can have authority over certain types of projects themselves to approve or not approve a line of detail on a project where they don't actually own the entire timesheet. So I'm just going to take a step back to my employee that I was working on, Mr. Apple here. So he's going to get approved. Let's take a look at how he did for the week. You know, well, he's supposed to be 50% billable, but he's only 31% billable. And, you know, if he had benefit hours, see how he did against benefit hours. I don't have any logged in there, but I can just print off his timesheet in a detailed or by project break at that point. So there you have it. That's really a summary of this application's timekeeping program. And just give me a second, and I'm going to move over to another manufacturer's timekeeper. And then later in the presentation, I will do expenses in two different applications.